Welcome to this exceptional press conference for Yamaha here after a very exciting announcement was made today. It's a great pleasure to welcome on stage, of course, Monster Energy Yamaha rider Valentino Rossi and also Managing Director of Yamaha Motor Racing, Lynn Jarvis. On the day where Valentino Rossi has signed an extension on his deal with Yamaha to join the Petronas Yamaha SRT team for 2021. Gentlemen, great to have you both here. I'd like to ask a few questions first about the deal that's been done today, and then we'll pass over to some journalists. Valentino, firstly, with you. At last, the paperwork is all signed off. You've been answering many questions about this for many, many months. Congratulations. You have made millions of fans so, so happy with this news that you're continuing riding in MotoGP. But more importantly, how happy are you to get this deal done?
I am very happy and very proud of this decision because I wanna continue to race. And it's a strange season. So my plan at the beginning is try to understand if I am still competitive. And after we spoke a lot with Lynn, with the Yamaha, and also with the Petronas team later. But it's good. It's a long time that I stay with the factory Yamaha from 2013, the second part, but from 2004, the first part. But I think that this move is good for me. And I have to thank Lynn and Yamaha because they continue to give me the factory support. So I think that will not change a lot. Change the color of the bike. And I'm happy because also the Petronas team is a very, very high level, very professional, and they already achieve a lot of important results.
Valentino, as you said, COVID-19 has of course affected so much across 2020. How long ago was it that you made the decision that you wanted to continue into 2021? And how important has it been for you that you've been competitive in 2020 and that you still have that speed?
Yeah, the story is like this, because in a normal situation, I asked to Yamaha to wait until Mugello, because I don't like the result of last year. I mean, I did a good first part of the season. I did some good races, but in a lot of occasion, I was in trouble. I don't feel good with the bike and I was not competitive enough for stay at the top level. So after when you started to have this problem at my age, you started to make some self-question, no? You say, when you look at the date of the born date of the other riders, and you understand that you are the oldest from 7 years to the second, you say maybe it's time to stay at home. but in my heart, I don't trust. I think that I can be competitive. For sure, it's not the same than 10 or 15 years ago when I can win 10 races in a season. Mm. But I think that if you are good with your body, the motivation can make the difference. So last year I decided to change something in my team, especially my chief mechanic, because I think that we can be strong, we can be anyway competitive, we can fight for the victory and for the podium. But after it's strange, because before arrived the COVID-19, around January, Lynn called us and say, I have to come at the WR46. And I said, it's not a good news, because sincerely, I expect this. I think it's normal, already from Thailand last year, because the problem is that, so Maverick was strong last year, and especially Quartararo did some incredible result, you know? So I say, maybe it's difficult to have the place also for 2021. And in fact, Lynn come from that. I always say that he come from fired me. but I don't want to say that it was good, but I think that is normal. But in that moment, I asked Tulin and I said, ah, but if I want to continue, you have to give me the third M1, because if I want to continue, what we do? So I put him a little bit of pressure. And already from that moment, he said to me, yes, okay, anyway, the relationship with you and Yamaha is something really special. So from that moment, we start to work at this project. And at the end, I'm very happy because I enjoy. And if I can be competitive, I want to race also next year. So I have to say thank you to Lynn, to all the Yamaha for the support, and also to the Petronas team, because I think that will be very nice to race with them.
Valentino, as you say, not a lot will change. The colours might change to aquamarine, and of course, you're still on a factory Yamaha, but there are a couple of people that aren't coming with you to the Petronas team. Could you just have say a few words about that? And also your thoughts on actually teaming up with Franco Morbidelli, your academy rider. I mean, that must just be a dream come true for you.
Yes, I fight a lot for all the team, but, you know, sometimes it's impossible. Also because in Petronas work a lot of good people. For me, during my career, it's always important to have my team. And, for example, with Alex Briggs, we are together from 2000, also with Bernie. But, you know, at this moment of my career, it's normal that cannot be everything perfect, you know? So I try to keep my chief mechanic, David, and Idaglio, Matteo. And unfortunately for Alex and for Brent, it's not possible. And it's a big shame. I'm sad about don't have them with me next year, but it's like this. And on the other side, it's very good to be with Franco, because he's our rider. And if you say to me or to Franco that we will race together 5 years ago, we say that is not true. It's not possible for him, but also for me. Maybe I already stopped. So this is good that I think that we can work together and we can raise our performance.
Valentino, congratulations. Thank you so much. You've made a lot of fans very happy, and hopefully some point in the future you'll be able to celebrate with your fans here at the circuit again. Thank you. I'm going to move over now to Managing Director of Yamaha, Lynn Jarvis. Lynn, I'm sure that you're happy to get this one over the line, because it seems like it's been running on for some time, but ultimately this amazing relationship between Yamaha and Valentino continues. How important is that for you, that all four current riders at Yamaha are staying with you, albeit some changes of teams and colours?
Yeah, anyway, for sure, I'm really, really happy to arrive to today. And we actually signed, I think we signed 17 minutes before the press release. So it's like, you know, really like that, and we got it done. So it was important. I said today it was 6 months from beginning to end, but Valentino reminded me actually it was 8 months from beginning to end. Yeah, it's a long process to bring it together, because it's complicated. Because anyway, you know, normally we had a contract just between Valley and us. And honestly, every renewal up until now has been very quick, very simple. Let's renew. OK, what's changed? This. OK, done. This time was more complicated, because obviously we renewed our agreement. So Valentino will remain a Yamaha motor factory rider, but we needed to place him into the Petronas team. That means we needed to find agreement with the Petronas team. They have their legal, we have our legal, Valentino has his legal, so we've got Japanese, Malaysian, Italians, you know, so to try to bring that together was quite complicated, but I'm super happy that we got it done, because, you know, having Valentino continue in this sport, I think it's so important for MotoGP. And I said that, you know, at the beginning of the year and as the year progressed, because it would completely not be correct if he had to stop his career in this COVID-influenced year. So I think it's fantastic that he will stay, not only because of that, but because he's still competitive, highly competitive. You know, he's just been on the front row press conference, back again since Silverstone, I was reminded. So, you know, he's still highly competitive, highly motivated, and loved by many, many fans around the world, and certainly in the Yamaha network, huge. We have a big history together. You know, since 2004, so with the exception of the 2 years when he was lost, we've been 15 years together. So kind of we know each other fairly well, and Yamaha, he's one of us, so it's great that he will continue with us. Having the four riders together, I think it's super. I think we have a fantastic group of riders, you know, with the experience of Valentino and the youth that we've got, also with the Maverick, Franco and Fabio. I said earlier this year, I think we have a super lineup of riders, and I'm really super happy to take that forward into next year. So, yeah, it's been a great day for me today, I think for the sport and certainly for Yamaha fans around the world.
The next question I know that fans will be asking around the world is it just 1 year? Is that 1 year and it's all over? Could you just explain the reasons behind a one-year deal? Because a lot of us are hoping that Valentino just continues and continues.
Yeah, 1 year, no, it's you know, in our negotiation, honestly, initially we proposed from Yamaha, initially we proposed one-year program to him. But then Vale said, hey, OK, it's nice, 1 year is good, but for my motivation, for my drive, I don't want to enter next year knowing that next year will be the end. So he said, I would like to keep the motivation that if I'm performing well, if I still enjoy, if I can prove I'm still fast enough, that I have the potential to continue in the future. And we agreed quite quickly, no? So top management of Yamaha agreed to that. The reason why we make it a one-year contract is a little bit more complicated with the contract. We have a contract with the Petronas team until the end of 21. We have a contract with Dorna for our participation in the championship until the end of 21. So we hope that we will renew, anyway, with the championship. I would say it's a foregone conclusion that we will renew for another five-year term as a constructor. And I hope that we can also continue with Petronas into the future. But unless you can sign off on that, you can't put that in the contract. So it's 1 year on paper, but we have a clear arrangement with each other that we will be discussing in the middle of next season whether Valentino wants to stay in the future. And if Petronas are happy, we're happy. Why not?
And just one last question before we pass to the journalists as well. How impressed have you been with the Petronas Yamaha SRT team in general? To be this their second year and to be able to have Valentino go into that setup, it almost feels like there's genuinely two factory teams out there. That's how good and strong that they have been. It's a credit to, of course, the team and yourselves.
Yeah, I think I would like to say that we got lucky because, you know, obviously we had this long relationship in the past with Tech 3. Then that changed and we needed to find a new satellite team because we like to have four riders on the grid. Raslan has told the story on numerous occasions. Anyway, we mid season when we knew that Tech 3 were going, then this opportunity came up and Raslan was able to step in and, you know, upgrade his team, which was, I think, then in Moto 3 and Moto 2, to take on the role in MotoGP. So it was really an interesting opportunity for us. They had good financial support from Petronas, but the results, I think, have surprised us and surprised many people. So chapeau to them. Sometimes they're too quick. So, you know, this is another issue. No, really, they're doing great, and that's why I think that Valentino will continue to perform on the same level, whether he's here or there.
Gentlemen, that's all for me. Thank you very much indeed. It's a chance now to open up the questions from members of the media on Zoom.
Hi, Vale. First of all, congratulations. One question for you. Can you hear me?
Yes.
You started as Rossi Fumi, then you became the doctor. Now we are speaking in the article like endless Rossi or eternal Peter Pan. What? How would you describe this new era?
I don't know. For sure, continue with the doctor, I think. But yeah, it's a long, long time. And maybe this is also a teach for the future, for the next riders, because a lot of riders stop when they are a lot younger than me. But maybe in our sport, you can continue with also when you are a little bit more old. And I always enjoy to stay here, and also I like to make this type of life. I think that my passion for ride the motorcycle is from when I was two, and it's the same. This make the difference. Yes, the important is to be strong and try to fight for the important position.
Thank you.
Grzegorz Jędrzejewski from Polsat Sport. A question first to Valentino and then to Lynn. Congratulations. Valentino, is there a chance, a future as a team owner, Yamaha team owner, after you finish the career? And question to Lynn, we know that Alex and Brent are leaving also the Yamaha factory team, not following Valentino. What was the reasoning for not extending the contract with those two very important person by the side of this young man, Valentino?
Allora, about the team is a bit early, but like Lynn said, at the end of 2021, the MotoGP changed for 2022. And maybe we can have the occasion to make a VR46 team in MotoGP, but really speaking, is really early, and for us is not easy because our organization, the dimension of our organization is good for Moto3, Moto2, but for MotoGP is a big step. So sincerely, I don't know. And for the bikes, Yamaha, why not? We already speak a little bit with Lynn. And why not? But you know, before we have to decide if we do the team or we continue with Moto3, Moto2, and after we will see.
Yeah, regarding your question on the staff, you know, as Valentino said, he's been with some of his people for many, many years, and this has been something which we, in fact, were a part of, because when we took Valentino from Honda many, many years ago, we brought him and his entire team with him, and we know that this has been important for him. But you can imagine other riders feel the same. So Fabio also, when he came to us, he also wanted to bring some people that he's familiar with and has confidence with as well. So this is a moment of, it's a kind of a changing of the guard. So we needed to find a way to accommodate Fabio and some of his requests with some of the expertise we already have in-house. So, you know, there's only so many places in the pit box, and so that meant that we, from the factory team, were unable to still offer an extension to Brent and Alex. And obviously, I've worked with Brent since, to be honest, I've worked with Brent since 99, so this is going back a few years. When the team was Marlboro Yamaha, Brent was with us in the beginning, and then Alex joined us since 2004. So we have a very good relationship. Of course, it would be nice to keep everybody happy, to have everybody on board, but sometimes you need to change a team as well. And so this is unfortunate, but I'd like to thank them for all of the contribution that they've done and are still doing for us right now.
Thank you.
Nadia Troncioni from El País. Question for Valentino. Vale, you told us, like, I think it was a few months ago even, that you were going to continue racing with Petronas 99%, but it's been so long since you closed the deal. So which has been the main reason it was hard to close the deal finally?
Because we enjoy. No, I mean, Nadia. So sincerely, when I was sincere with you, with all the press, and I don't remember where, but I said that I will race 99% with the Petronas. I think where in Brno, maybe, or in Jerez. In Jerez, maybe, at the beginning. So for me, from that moment, the situation is over. The decision is taken. Also because I know that the Yamaha say yes and Petronas say yes. So in general, we are not in a hurry, you know. So like Lynn explained, it's a bit more difficult because it's a contract between three parts and not just between me and the Yamaha. Because usually in the last 6 years, We just resigned the same contract with some small modification, but it's very quick. So it's more time, but, and also we don't put pressure. We wanna see the Raslan and the Petronas guy also in direct in VR46 in Misano, and just for this, we don't have any particular problem. We speak also about the team, and we need a negotiation also because Fabio bring. His mechanics, his guy to the factory team, so this needs some time, but in general is because we are not in a hurry.
Hi guys, this is Frank Weijink from Eurosport, the Netherlands. I've two questions for Lynn and for Valentino. Lynn, first of all, you say that the support for Valentino will be the same. Does that mean that if there's going to be updates during the season, that Valentino is going to get them in the same, let's say, the same moment as Maverick and Fabio? And also, did it take a lot of persuading to get the Petronas team to be convinced that they would have a good rider with Valentino? Because we know that sort of their strategy is educating young riders, and Valentino is not really a young rider, to be honest. Questions to you, and then Valentino. It means that you will work with a lot of new people. You've been with the factory team since 2014, your second stint, and now you've got a new team manager, a lot of new people around you. How do you think that you are going to cope with that, if you know what I mean?
So, good question anyway, Frank. So regarding the factory support, anyway, we will supply, let's say the best way to imagine it is anyway, at the beginning of the season, when we start in the first Grand Prix, then Valentino will have exactly the same bike as the factory boys. So when we start the season, everything will be the same. And as we progress throughout the year, sometimes it may be possible to give updates all at the same time. Sometimes it may not. So obviously in a factory team, and Valentino knows himself, he's been in the factory team for so long, we can only do so much at the time. So if we want to move forward, we have limited possibility, we need to try something out, then it may be done by the factory team as a priority. If it's working well, then we will supply it to Valentino on the first opportunity. But it's not easy to say that it's black and white, because we are accustomed to, even now, we work with three different, you know, the base is the same for Fabio, Vale and Maverick right now. But sometimes, you know, even last week we did a test. We brought various new parts. This guy selected this bit, this guy selected that bit, and the other guy selected that bit. So it depends upon what's being developed for what we will supply on time. And the other part of your question was?
Yeah, the other part was about...
Yeah, but they're a young rider. No, I would say, in that sense, in the beginning, there are two factors, of course. It's true that their philosophy is basically to bring up from Moto3, Moto2, up into the MotoGP class. And hopefully in the future, they wish to do that with Malaysian riders as well. So this is a part of their project. So, of course, in one sense, Valentino is not fitting in line with that normal structure and strategy. But Valentino Rossi is Valentino Rossi, and he is not just any rider. So he brings something much, much more to the team. So they recognize that immediately, that they're, you know, this is something big, something special, can really add value to their team. They had some concern about whether he would be competitive, because indeed, we took the decision way back when we were not even racing because of this COVID situation. So I think at the first moment, okay, they understood the concept, but they had the same concern that maybe we and Valentino had, let's say, 6 months before. But he soon proved that he was competitive, and that took away any doubt from the Petronas team, and then they were full on and totally in agreement to continue.
Allora, about me, abbiamo detto, I'm not very worried under that point of view. First of all, because anyway, the heart of my team, I mean, chief mechanic and data analyst remain the same. But also because I know very well the Petronas team, I don't know Raslan before than this year personally, but for example, I know very well Zellenberg, that is the team manager, because we worked together in the factory team in Yamaha. Also, if we worked with Jorge, but we were together. I know very well Stiggy, because we raced together when we were more young, like in the European Championship in 94 or in 95. And I know very well also Roger, that is the truck driver, that is a great man, that he worked with me, with the Repsol factory team. So for me, it's like stay at home. So it's, I think, no problem.
Okay, guys, Taufik from TMC Blog, Trans7 Indonesia. I would like to ask two questions for Lin and Vale. For Lin, you had informed that the reasons Yamaha Motor Company only extends 1 year Rossi contracts was because the manufacturer contracts term ended in 2021 with Dorna. The one that I wondering is, then how can Yamaha be sure to sign Maverick and Fabio until, if I'm not wrong, 2022? That's the question for Lin. And for Vale, your renewal opens the opportunity for you to come back to Indonesian GP next year, maybe, yeah? After you've been in Indonesia in, I don't know, in a GP 125 period, how much do you want to be present at Mandalika next year as a MotoGP starter? Thank you.
Yeah, in answer to your first question, yeah, when I said about contracts and I mentioned two contracts, however, I mentioned our participation with Dorna, but I also mentioned our contract with the Sepang team. So we can't guarantee a place for Valentino if we don't have a satellite team. So in order to have a satellite team, first we need to sign with the Dorna agreement so that we confirm ourselves as participants in the championship. But I have no doubt we will do that. I have no doubt we will be here. So therefore, it's, shall we say, from our top management, we can confirm the factory riders. But it's very difficult to confirm a third rider because you can't place a third rider in the factory team. So unless you have a confirmed satellite team, you can't put it in a contract, as simple as that. So there's nothing negative, just it's a technicality.
Yes, for sure. I race in Indonesia, in Sentul, I think, with the 125. I also won, I think, in 97. I was been in Indonesia a lot of times after that, because we had some PR day with Yamaha, and it's unbelievable the passion for MotoGP in Indonesia is incredible. Sometimes it's also difficult to control. And so I'm very happy to be there, because we will have a lot of fans, and also the track will be very interesting, new from zero. I saw some drawing, it's close to the sea. Is something, is a new project, you know? So, yes, I hope to come.
Hello, I'm Gonzalo from Motorcycle Sports. I have just one question for Jarvis. Yamaha renewed with Vinales and signed with Quartararo until 2022. But you said you couldn't make a contract with Rossi because you should make a contract for something you can deliver. Can you explain this difference?
Maybe you didn't hear my last answer to the Indonesian man. Maybe you didn't hear it. Okay. Anyway, okay. Better listen next time. We need to renew our participation for the championship from 22 to 26. So I have no doubt that Yamaha will do that. But we do not have a contract also with the Sepang team beyond the end of 21. So to offer a position to Vinales and Quartararo is something we can do, because we will surely have a factory team in 22 and beyond. But we need to secure a satellite team, because you cannot have three riders in the factory team. So it's a technicality, that's all.
Okay.
Hi. First of all, as a fan of MotoGP, Vale, I tell you that I am very happy with your continuity, okay? For Zavala in this case. And like a journalist, I would like to ask you, what is the secret of your eternal youth and your passion for racing?
Well, you know, I growing up with my father, that he was a rider, and the first things that I remember is that I love to follow him, to see him, and especially motorcycle. Because when I start to remember already, Graziano raced with cars, but he put me on the bike very, very early, and I think that it was... So now it's more normal. But I think that I am the first rider of the new generation. I mean, I start very, very early, and I think this is one very important for arrive at the top. And I think that that Graziano enjoy a lot, put me on the bike, and try to see if I did some disaster or how much I risk. So. Is the passion, I think, because is a good life, but it's very, you have a lot of pressure, and especially now, if you are a MotoGP rider, you are a real athlete, so you need to train every day, you need to make a certain type of life, so it's not easy. But if the taste, when you go on the bike and you enter in the track, if you have that taste that you are happy, I think that this is the secret. Maybe for some others, this finish, and if this feeling finish after become everything very heavy.
Hi, good evening, Tommy from Sport 5 Israel. I have congratulations. I have one question for Vale and one question for Lynn. Valentino, there's an ongoing debate now that you're joining a satellite team. If the Nastro Ozzaro Honda, was it a satellite team or was it a factory team? And a question for Lynn, when I spoke to Razlan a few months ago, he said that he would rather his team won't be called as a satellite team, but more like a Yamaha 2-1 or something like that, team A, team B. What do you think about that? Do you still see it as really a satellite team? Because it's a little bit more like a factory one.
Yeah, the Nastro Azzurro was a real satellite team, because is exactly what's happened now with the Petronas or with all the satellite teams. So now all the satellite team is an important project for everybody, for the factory, because usually in the satellite team you have the young riders for the factory team, and now the bike is exactly the same in a lot of occasions. The bike in the satellite team is same than in the factory. And then the Nastro Azzurro team was exactly the same. I had the factory bike, I had my team with the Jeremy Bargis, but I was in the satellite team. And I read somewhere that I am the only rider that win the Premier Class Championship with the satellite team in 2001. So this is good. This is good for next year. I will try also next year.
Yeah, Tammy, in answer to your question, what Razlan said. Anyway, I can only say that factory team basically refers to ownership. You know, I think each factory has their factory team. So I would refer to the Petronas team as factory supported team. So, you know, we have our Japanese engineers working inside that team. You know, there's Olin's technician. Our Michelin technician is for both sides of the garage. So we can't call it a factory team because the ownership is Sepang Racing Team. It's a Malaysian team, but it's definitely a factory-supported team.
Gentlemen, the MotoGP story with Valentino and Yamaha continues. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Facciamo finta così, vai, allora foto, eh? Thank you guys.